Susanna, hello, good afternoon. Tell us about your role in this film, Mona Darling.
It's a very interesting role. I think she's the title character of the film, and the whole film is basically how this girl disappears and everybody's trying to find out what's happening, and there are some murders that are happening or sab kuch kisi tarah interconnected hai, aur ye ek character aisa hai ki aapko आखिर तक बहुत इंट्रीक करने वाला है कि आखिर है कौन और क्या करने की कोशिश कर रही है. वेदर शी इज़ अ गर्ल नेक्स्ट डोर और वेदर शी इज़ समथिंग एल्स, इट हैज़ दिस सेंस ऑफ इंट्रीक थ्रू आउट द फ्लो ऑफ द फिल्म, दिस पर्टिकुलर कैरेक्टर. सो या आई थिंक इट्स वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंट्रीगिंग कैरेक्टर्स दैट आई हैव डन टिल नाउ.
व्हाट वाज इट अबाउट द स्क्रिप्ट दैट हुक्ड यू?
I think the script in itself, the story and the plot lines, they were so well written. Every single thing, every single movement, every single hand gesture was mentioned in the script, and it was so precise. Everything had a meaning, and I've never worked on a script like that, which was this detailed. And I think it really interested me to work with Shashi, our director, because I loved his vision and I thought he could make something really, really interesting.
You studied MBA in finance. How was the shift to reality shows and then to films?
Well, MBA in finance, trust me, I didn't do it just because I wanted to. It was more, I come from a small town, okay, so, and I was always a good student, so you're expected to either become a doctor, engineer, as usual. And I didn't want to do any of that. I always knew I wanted to be an actress or do something in this field, but I never had the guts to say it probably because yeah, you don't talk about such things, you know, people laugh at you if you do. But MBA, when that happened, that is when roadies happened at the same time, while I was still a student and studying, and that kind of gave me that pathway to kind of break free. So I did my roadies, came back, finished my education, and then went back to Bombay and started struggling.
But your parents were okay with the whole?
They were not okay exactly, but they've been very, very supportive. Initially, yes, but I think they see me happy now and they see that she's doing something that she loves. So that makes them proud of me. And I don't know if they're proud of me, that's a big thing to say, but at least they're supportive and they know that I'm doing the right thing for me, at least.
Okay. Yeah. Talking about the film is has a background of social media. Speaking of which, have you had any wacky social media anecdotes that you could share with us?
Well, actually, I've been very lucky because me and my co-actor Divya were actually discussing this, that have we been harassed ever on social platforms? And she has. She's had some very weird messages coming her way. There was a time that she even went off social media because she just couldn't handle it anymore. But I don't know, I've been really lucky. I've never had, I get those weird messages, you want to do friendship and shit like that, but never anything to, you know, offend me or say bad things about me. So I guess I've been lucky. I've not been a target yet, touch wood. Yeah.
You're known to know 6 languages. I mean, that's really impressive. That's what your Wikipedia page says,
yes,
by the way.
Yes, yes, yes.
So any plans of exploring the regional cinema medium or any, I don't know, international film, Russian, Ukrainian?
I would love to, especially if it's something international, something very, I would love to do a film festival kind of a film where I can use all my skills together and make the most of it. And actually there's something very interesting coming my way very soon. So I hope I'll get to put that language skill set to some good use finally. Yeah.
Okay. How was it working with Shashi? He's a first time director. Yes, so how was the whole experience?
Oh, it was amazing. I think with Shashi, he is not a very good man with first impressions, mind me. He comes across like very, very serious, and serious is good, but he doesn't come across very approachable when you just meet him, and that's not a good thing for a director. But within a few meetings, he's just, because you know how clear he is, how you may get along with him, you may not get along with him at times, but he is so clear about what he wants from you and he knows how to get it from you. And I think that conviction of his just pulled us through the whole thing. Yeah.
Okay. Speaking about social media, the way things are going on currently, there are a lot of trolling happening, a lot of objectionable content being uploaded. What is your personal opinion? Is social media necessary evil today, or?
I think it's necessary, but in today's time, especially in the kind of field that we are, so we cannot really avoid it. But it does have a very bad side effect, as I would like to put it, because I've realized one thing. There was this one quote that I saw somewhere. Just notice, you never go into Facebook and come out happier. You know, and I don't know how true is that, but that's actually a fact, because it takes away your real time, the time that you're supposed to live. We are all day these days, kids are on social media, and somewhere we are forgetting to live, actually live, and just talk about living on social media. So I think there has to be a balance, which probably we will achieve with time, because we are all trying to find a balance with everything today. So
how addicted are you to social media?
I don't really like social media, honestly. I do it because I have to, and you get a lot of, being an actor, you get noticed a lot on social media, you get contacted. It's all work, and it's not fun for me, I would say. I don't enjoy. I'm one of those people who will just go on social media for 10 minutes, post whatever she needs to, and just get out of there, because I feel low if I'm on social media for a very long time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Recently, there was this talks of digital censorship, as they call it. Mm-hmm. Are you in favor of it, or do you think social media should be open for people to express whatever they want, irrespective of the impact?
I didn't get your first part of the question.
There were talks about digital censorship, that mm-hmm. there should be some kind of a censorship on what people put up on social media.
Okay.
And there is another school of thought which says, no, it's an open forum. People are supposed to be free to express whatever they want.
Well, that's a very tricky place to be in, because though I do love the fact, the reason even I am doing some web work at present, and the reason that I'm doing that is because there's no censorship. You can really experiment, have fun with your roles, don't care about every single word that comes out of your mouth.
True.
So those things are great, no doubt, but certain amount of censorship is necessary. Especially when it influences, I think, the younger minds, and not in a good way, when it's something violent or it's something that exposing them to not a very happy zone, I would say. Because kids today, they are very, they get influenced very easily, like we did when at that age. And I think internet is so easily accessible today that some censorship is definitely required, some kind of, but I don't know, actually. This is a very tricky question. There has to be a balance again. I don't think it can work either just this way or either that way. It has to be, there has to be a mid-ground there.
Coming back to the film, what would you say was your toughest scene to film in the movie?
My toughest scene? I wouldn't say it was hard for me to shoot anything for the film, but dubbing for this film was very, very tricky for me.
Okay.
Because I think some Mona Darling magic happened, and 2-3 of the major scenes that I had in the film, there was some sound issue that we realized only when we started dubbing for it. So there was absolutely no sound for my big scenes, and we had to and I had spoken a lot of gibberish, I was improvising there, so we didn't know exactly what I had spoken. So we had to narrow it down second per second and figure out what I was saying. So that was a very hard thing for me. But shooting wise, I think it went like a breeze. It was so fast that pata hi nahi chala kab shuru ho gaya, khatam ho gaya. So yeah, I think it was really good. It was pretty breezy. I wouldn't say anything.
Tell us about your co-stars. What kind of a equation you had with them?
I think that was the best part for me. In fact, I've been very lucky with all my projects when it comes to co-actors. I've never had bad.
Touch wood again.
Yeah, trust me. But with Divya and Anshuman particularly, we fit so easily. Not just on screen with as our characters, but even personally. We would have every meal together, wake up in each other's rooms, and have slumber parties, watch films, do everything together. And even today, we just click, especially Divya and I. It's been 7-8 months that we've started shooting for this film. From the time we've started shooting for this film, and every week we would make a point to go out. So I've met some great people. With Sanjay ji, yes, I didn't spend much time with him. He was there on set for a very short period of time, and so my interaction with him was very limited. But he seems like a great guy. I kind of had a crush on him. during Jhankar Beats time, which I never told him. But yeah, so I had to be all nice and composed whenever I would meet him. And so it was a good environment. Everybody was there to work and for all the right reasons. So yeah, we had a lot of fun.
Speaking of thrillers, which is your favorite thriller and why?
Oh, my favorite thriller. Well, actually, thriller is not much of my genre.
Okay.
But please don't laugh on me, but there was this one in Hindi, if I can remember, there's this one film that really freaked me out, like when I was a child, because horror never spooked me. Okay. But there was this one film called Kaun, directed by Ram Gopal Varma, in which Urmila turns out to be this weird psycho, ghost, not ghost kind of a thing in the end. And I couldn't sleep like for 3 nights. Like that freaked me out, that movie. So yeah, I would say that was one very, very scary thing.
What are your upcoming projects now?
For now, I have a web series which is on Sony, and there are some other projects, but I would rather talk about them when we can officially make an announcement. So yeah.
Thanks for talking to us, Susanna. All the best
Thank
for
you.
Your film.
Thank you.